Everybody seems to think that Macs are the best computers for music production or the best laptops for music production. I'm here to open your eyes and tell you that's not the case. I've tried to maintain a very unbiased view in my last few videos about laptops and computers for music production, but lately it has become very painfully clear that Apple just don't give a shit about professional users like music producers. As a former Apple fanboy, I have my fair share of Apple products. So this video doesn't come from fear or ignorance. No, it comes from 10 years of experience of using the most overrated and overpriced products on the planet. And I started using Apple products because I intensely hate Microsoft as a computer programmer and everything it stands for. But now I can say of the two worst, the PC is definitely the better option. And it's not macOS. macOS is the best part of Apple. Let me go back a little, because there was a time, 10, 15 years ago, maybe 20 years ago, that the Mac was indeed better suited for music production, but the PC has caught up big time and is better suited for music production than ever before. The only valid reason that you could say that a Mac is better for music production is because, well, the support for sound drivers is a little bit poor under Windows, but that doesn't make it sound any less, for example. But with DAWs supported for Mac and Windows, the PC is just the better option. So why are people so hung up on the idea that Mac is better for music production? This is the problem with Apple. Apple's priorities lie with their iPhones. They make up the biggest share of their revenue, so they have the most attention and the most developers behind it. And when we're talking about the iPhone, what super features are added to the iPhone over the last 5 years? And what super features are added to iOS over the last 5 years? iCloud then, which generates duplicate entries on my iPhone. Safari then, how many web pages do work properly? 4 out of 5? The usability of iTunes and the crashes in Final Cut Pro, the bugs in Logic! By now you may think that there is something wrong with your screen. No, that's a design feature. Let me get rid of that design feature. So, much better. I can go on and on about bad Apple stuff, but we're here for the laptops and computers for music production and why they're bad. The biggest problem with Apple is that they simply stopped caring about the quality of their products and treats their professional users like music producers as beta testers. The T2 chips. T2 chips are meant for encryption, so your data is safe. At least that is the official statement by Apple. But what they're really meant for is so you can't repair your own computer. But there is another problem with that. T2 chips are reported in January 2018 to crash your Macs. By the shoot of this video, the problems still weren't fixed. The MagSafe connector. The MagSafe connector was a magnetic connection that when you applied too much force on it, it would automatically disconnect. When you, for example, tripped over the wire, it disconnected your laptop. When you picked up your laptop, for example, without realizing that the laptop was still connected to the power, it would save your laptop, and it saved mine at least a dozen of times. However, Apple ditched the connection in favor of the USB-C connection. Why? They want you to return your MacBook to the store so they can charge you money for it. They want your MacBook to be broken. Back in the days when I was working in a computer store, the reason why most laptops were returned to the store was because someone tripped over the power cord and broke the power connection on the motherboard. The problem with that is that they are not easily fixable. Computers for music production can be a complicated matter, so I wrote a special chapter about it in my free ebook. You can download it, the link is in the description below. Also are in there super useful tips and tricks for DJs and producers. Regular keyboards worked fine since the 1970s. Then, a couple of years back, Apple released the Butterfly keyboards on their MacBook Pros. The MacBook Pros are the laptops for professional users that cost 3,000 to 5,000 euros. Again, Apple didn't test their shit. So the Butterfly keyboards broke with thousands at a time. So they made a second version without testing it, which, surprise, surprise, failed by the thousands. So they made a third version of the Butterfly keyboards. I know that a certain someone would turn around in his grave. In 2018, Apple released a new MacBook Pro without testing it. And it turned out, after the release, that it had thermal throttling issues. The most expensive CPU, the i9, turned out to be so hot under optimal performance that it had to slow down, otherwise it would kill itself. And the performance was equal to the cheaper i7 processor in the MacBook. And it was only after the pressure of the media that Apple finally fixed the problem with the software update. Then the stability argument. Oh yes, the ancient old stability argument. Well, Macs crash all the time. This one does crash, that one does crash, with Final Cut at least once a day. Even if it's proprietary Apple products, they still crash and they don't test their products. I say a well-built PC, if you don't cheap out on components, is as stable as a Mac. Apple goes through great lengths to prevent you from repairing your own stuff or even upgrading it. First of all, it's super difficult to open your machine. The T2 chips I mentioned earlier are solely there so you can't repair your own machine. Then they sold their CPUs to the motherboard, the memory to the motherboard, and the SSD to the motherboard solely so you can't swap those components. So you overpaid for the hardware in the first place, and then they try to retain ownership of the products you bought from them. And everyone is okay with that? That Apple doesn't care about its professional customers was made painfully clear by the Mac Pro. Years ago, Apple released the Mac Pro that resembled a trash can. Expansion was difficult and the system wasn't updated for years. So old hardware, super old hardware in a new computer you buy, and still they asked top dollar for it. Okay, they released an update, but still it went on for years and shows clearly that you are not a priority. I can go on and on about a lot of stuff, but in short, the terrible Bluetooth support in Apple products. My PlayStation has no problems at all. The USB port problems with this system. Apple, what is this? This? The huge trackpads that cause accidental touches. The mini jack connections that lag in the iPhone. The absence of SD card slots in MacBooks. Then the price increase of 20 to 30% of your whole product spectrum. The lies about pretty much everything, the flat out lies. For example, well, slowing down your iPhones so you can sell new ones. The closed ecosystem. The suitcase full of dongles you have to travel with when you're taking with you your Apple equipment. Then the persistent alarming messages of Apple refusing to repair products properly. But I hope you finally get it. Apple doesn't care. Just be smart about it, buy a PC. And if we keep buying inferior stuff from companies like Apple, they will never learn.